Wisconsin's most high-profile Senate recall race really about re-electing President Obama.
That's what Senator Alberta Darling claims is behind the effort to unseat her.
Darling and her challenger, Sandy Pasch, faced off in their final debate today. 12 News' Kent Wainscott is here with their battle, new at 6.
And it is crunch time in this race. Voters in the 8th Senate District will cast their recall ballots just 6 days from now, but the candidates are still talking about the reason that they believe the whole recall effort began.
What they thought was right for their people.
Alberta Darling laid it on the line, contending that the real reason behind the Senate recall race is actually the race for the White House.
This is about the Obama election. Obama cannot win unless he wins Wisconsin. That's why you see all this money in here. That's why you see all the arrows and guns pointed at me, because we had the audacity to take on the special interest groups and say, you know what? We are Wisconsin.
In their final debate, Darling accused challenger Sandy Pasch of shifting her focus away from collective bargaining changes because Darling says those changes are working. But Pasch fired back, claiming the recall effort was always about Darling and her handling of many different issues.
They are recalling you because you have cut quality of education, quality of health, quality of life for many, many people.
The questions for the candidates came from the audience, and several focused on the economy, with the candidates taking sides over the type of jobs being created in Wisconsin.
When we got in January, we had a jobs agenda that did major litigation reform, that did major regulatory reform, and put incentives for businesses who brought their jobs, brought new jobs into Wisconsin. We got in, had incentives for them, and that is working.
The jobs that were created were many temporary jobs and seasonal jobs. And while I do applaud all jobs, we need them, what we have to do is make sure that we grow family-supporting jobs, the jobs that come with benefits, jobs that are competitive, jobs that allow a family to really thrive in our state. And we're not doing that by what we're doing.
It was a fairly low-key event. Darling continued to try to link Pasch to former Governor Jim Doyle, something she's done often throughout the campaign, while Pasch again repeatedly focused on Darling's support of Governor Scott Walker and his policies.
Was there any talk about the election fraud accusations we've been hearing about over the last few days?
They've been going back and forth. Nothing at all during the debate today. Afterward, a little bit of political jousting. Pasch again denying any coordination between her campaign and the liberal third party group of which she's a board member. Darling saying she doesn't believe Pasch, and both saying they're waiting to hear from the Government Accountability Board on this and several other complaints on both sides.
And this phase ends Tuesday.
You bet.
All right. Thanks, Ken.